So far, we have discussed the Schrödinger wave equation in one dimension. Now, from chapter 4, we will start with quantum mechanics in three dimension, and we will solve the Schrödinger wave equation in spherical polar coordinates. So, let me start with the time independent Schrödinger wave equation, which is H sine equals E sine, where H is the Hamiltonian, which is a combination of kinetic energy and potential energy, and E is the energy. H is the operator and psi is the eigenfunction, E is the eigenvalue, and the time dependent Schrödinger wave equation is H psi equals I h bar curly psi over curly t. Now the H I can write is, this is equal to the classical value 1 over 2 mv square plus V, where V is the potential. And I can write this by momentum representation P square over 2m plus V, and this P square in component form I can write is Px square plus Py square and Pz square. This is whole divided by 2m, and this is V. While the Px, Py and Pz, I know that they are the momentum operators, which is I h bar curly psi over curly x, curly by curly x. Now psi here, so this is minus I h bar curly by curly x. Similarly, Py is minus I h bar curly by curly y, and Pz is minus I h bar curly by curly z. So I can write that the momentum operator in three dimension can be written as P, and this will be minus I h bar, and I will write del. So del is equal to, we know that the del operator is equal to curly by curly x and I plus curly by curly y in, better I write, not to confuse this I with this I, so better I write x here, and here I write y, and here I write z unit vector. So when it becomes here the P squared, this will become del squared, and del squared is equal to, when I multiply, del dot del. So these are vectors, so vector multiplication, del dot del is equal to curly square by curly x square plus curly square by curly y square and curly square by curly z square. This is the value of del square, and I can write the Schrödinger equation in three dimension is minus h bar square over 2m del square psi plus v psi is equal to E psi. So this will be equal to E psi. This is for the time independent Schrödinger wave equation, and I can write the time dependent Schrödinger wave equation is the same, minus h bar square over 2m del square psi plus v psi equals I h bar and curly psi over curly T. Now, we will have to note here that our psi as well as our V are functions of R and T. So, I can write that this psi, which is a function of R and T, in component form, I can write psi as a function of x, y, z and t. Here, it's depend on the space as well as on time. And the volume element, I can write like the probability density. If I write, this was psi mod square dx in one dimension. Now it will be d for dx, dy and dz. So I will write dx, dy, dz. As the wave function is normalized in space, so we are having only the space dependence here, and this will be equal to 1. I can write this thing like this as well, that psi mod square, and then for this I write d cube r, and I can also write psi mod square and d tau, and this is equal to 1, where d tau is the volume element. So I can write that the normalization constant will be this, and this is normalized only in space, but this psi is a function of space and time as well. Now, if this potential, is not depending on time, but only the wave function is depending on R and T, and our potential is only space dependent, while our wave function is space and time dependent, then I can write for such a potential which is only space dependent, I can write that sin r t, psi r t will be equal to let me write an index here, then psi n r t will be equal to psi n, which is a function of only r, and e to the power minus I e n t over h bar. So we can define psi r t as psi n r t as stationary states. These are the normalized stationary states, and which we call the bases of the Hilbert space, and this is the time dependent portion. So this is having the time evolution by this factor. And further, I can write that this psi n is actually satisfying the time independent Schrödinger wave equation. So this is time independent Schrödinger wave equation, and here we are having this psi n will satisfy the time independent Schrödinger wave equation, and in three dimension I can write my wave function psi of r t is equal to summation on n and c n. These are the coefficients which are called the probability. Their mod square will give the probability density, and psi n r e to the power minus I e n t over h bar. So this will give us our total wave function, which will satisfy the time-dependent Schrödinger wave equation. This equation, it will satisfy. So we will have to go to the spherical polar coordinates, the spherical polar coordinates. The spherical polar coordinates I have discussed already in the review of classical electrodynamics, so one may consult there that our wave function will now be, is, it's a function of r, and r I can write is, this is x, y and z, the space coordinates, and then the time coordinate is there. So now our wave function we will consider in terms of spherical polar coordinates. So it will be the radial part, which is the space, and then the angular portion, which is theta and phi. And for r, we know that r is extending from zero to any value, while theta means r will give us the radius of the vector, which will be in the spherical polar coordinates. Theta is the zenith angle, which extends from zero to a maximum value of pi, so it will go along the z axis, and phi will go from 0 to 2 pi. I can sketch this thing here, that if this is the coordinate system, which I call the x, y and z, this is our vector, which is r here with us. This is our vector r, and now this angle which it makes with the z axis, this vector r is actually the zenith angle, and we call this theta. So it starts from here, on z axis it is zero, and it will go, and on the minus z axis it will become pi. So it will make a D shape. First, the radius will go from 0 to certain value r, and then this radius will rotate and it will make D shape, and this D shape will then rotate to 2 pi. If I take the projection of this on the xy plane, then I can write that this will be the projection of this vector. So this and this vector are exactly parallel to each other, parallel and same. This component is same as this one, and if I make its cut on the x-axis and then the y-axis, then it is, this side is the same as this side, and this side is this side. Now this vector, our projection of this will move in this plane from 0 to 2 pi. So it will move this d from 0 to 2 pi, and that d will make us a sphere. So these are the spherical polar coordinates, and we know that r, theta and phi are interconvertible with x and y and z. So the z is equal to r cos theta from here, is we substitute, or as we resolve this vector into components, the x is r sine theta cos phi, r sine theta cos phi, and y is r sine theta sine phi. So these are the conversions. X square plus y square plus z square will be equal to r square. Similarly, we can derive the other interconversions. So we will now solve is our geometry here is that we are considering a spherical geometry, and on that spherical geometry we will solve the Schrödinger wave equation. So here our theta is running from 0 to pi, and our phi angle, which is this angle, the projection which is running on the plane of xy, it is going from 0 to 2 pi. So I consider that my wave function psi r theta phi, this is the wave function. Now it depends on the radial portion, which is r, and on the angular portion, which is theta and phi. So I will use the separation of variable technique, as we have used it earlier as well in classical electrodynamics. So the psi r of theta and phi, let me write this as capital R is the function of r, and capital Y is the function of theta and phi. Keep in mind one thing, that this r and this y are actually the wave functions. R is that wave function which depends only on the space, and y is that wave function which depends only on the angles theta and phi. So we will now come to the time independent Schrödinger wave equation, which is h psi equals e psi, and we have written this thing is in terms of del square. Now I will write here minus h bar square root 2m del square psi plus v psi equal e psi. We will now solve actually this equation. In three dimension, we will solve this equation, and I can write that del square in spherical polar coordinates, we can derive del square in spherical polar coordinates by the chain rule, and it is equal to 1 over r square curly by curly r square curly by curly r, and plus 1 over r square sine of theta and curly by curly theta sine of theta and curly by curly theta, and plus 1 over r square sine square theta curly square by curly phi squared. This is the value of del square in the spherical polar coordinates. As we